As director of biostatistics in the Duke Cancer Institute and the national director of the Statistical Center of the Cancer and Leukemia Group B, Stephen George has played a major role in the design, conduct, and analysis of cancer clinical trials. He has launched statistical groups for the European Organization for Research and Treatment of Cancer at the University of Brussels, Belgium, St. Jude's Children's Hospital, and of course, Duke.
I've written some papers concerning how you design these studies and how big they should be, how long they should go on, and what you should do in these studies. And your purpose is to see at the end of the day whether or not the treatments being compared, one treatment is better than another.
Since he was young, George has been drawn to numbers and earned his undergraduate degree in mathematics. He then became fascinated with the field of statistics.
That is how you can study phenomena, gather data, design experiments, and draw conclusions.
While earning his PhD in experimental statistics, his interest took a turn toward medicine during a summer internship at MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, where he performed statistical studies on pediatric cancer.
I was looking for something that had real-world applications and found it in the application of statistics to biology and medicine.
His career path was set. He spent 7 years in the Department of Biomathematics at MD Anderson and the University of Texas, then moved to St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital in Memphis, where he eventually became chairman of Biostatistics and Information Systems. He came to Duke in 1988 as director of biostatistics and established and grew a statistical group at the Duke Cancer Institute.
He has been honored as a fellow of both the American Statistical Association and the Society for Clinical Trials.
George and his wife Carolyn have been married for 50 years. They have a daughter who lives in Canada and has 3 children.
Now that the kids are a little older, we'll probably be doing more things up there.
They also plan to visit Brussels, where he still has friends. Reading, photography, and tennis also will highlight his retirement. With his tennis game, one has to wonder if he ever applied statistical analysis to his game in hopes of improving.
I'm an enthusiastic but fairly inept tennis player, so it probably wouldn't help me that much.
He has, however, found the holy grail of strategies for winning at tennis.
Get the ball back in the court one more time than your opponent.